On this week's episode of the Business TV Show on VooVix TV, we delve into the remarkable journey of a visionary in the world of real estate and business. Join us as we explore the dynamic career of Balvinder Singh Sahni, also known as Abu Sabah, the founder and chairman of RSG Group of Companies. Balvinder Singh Sahni, the driving force behind RSG Group of Companies, has steered the organization into a multi-billion dirham empire spanning the Middle East, the US, and South Asia. His strategic prowess in property transactions exceeding AED 5 billion has firmly established him among Dubai's property heavyweights. But Abu Sabah's vision extends beyond transactions. He aims to develop 4,500 units in 5 years across the UAE, the US, Russia, and Europe.
Gentlemen, welcome to the Business TV Show on VooVix TV. Now, our guest today is the chairman of RSG Group of Companies. Now, this is a company that has been in operation for 70 years, first in the automotive industry and then obviously dominating the real estate industry. And this company is one of the most iconic companies out there. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome Abu Sabah. Abu, how are you?
I'm good, buddy. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Welcome to the Business Show.
Thank you very much.
Look, Abu, it's great to have you here on the show. I mean, all our viewers, over 4.5 million subscribers, always talk about your antics, the entrepreneurship of yourself. But let's go back to the very start. Now, this company started 70 years ago. Can you tell us a little bit, just briefly, about the history of the company?
You know, my father came to Kuwait 75 years before. He had a hard time before. He was working very hard. And then I think my brothers came to Kuwait and they started supporting my father. And the company grew. And when I was born, I think that was the first time the business started moving in a different way. And since I was 8 years old, I loved to work with my father. So I used to go to school, and in the evenings, I never used to go and play with my friends. I used to go to my father's showrooms. You know, they had car spare parts, automotive, you know. So I used to go there, I used to see how my father, you know, they used to put acid in the batteries, you know. It was a tough time. But I always wanted to be better and be different.
That's crazy. Now, my father owned one of the biggest banks in Africa. And when he passed away, his family took the banks and we didn't get to inherit it. So I made my first million at age 20. How does it feel to take as a legacy? Was that a little bit of pressure? Because obviously your father has worked on this company and to make it successful. Was it a little bit of pressure on you taking that to make sure it was consistently successful?
It is different. I did not take my father's legacy. Mm-hmm. I took his blessings.
Amazing.
Yeah. Amazing. Because you know, we are big, we are six brothers. Mm-hmm. So they all had a pie in the cake. But I always wanted to be alone, and all were laughing at me. They say, I said, I don't want to work with my father. I want to work alone. So when I was 19, I was alone.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow.
And one of my brothers, he really supported me. He trusted me and he believed in me. Mm. And I think 35 years before I was 19, yeah, he gave me a $300,000 loan. And he said, I trust you and I know you're going to do it. I returned him the money 1 year back.
Wow.
After that. One year after that.
Amazing. Yeah. Amazing. Now look, innovation is a key to the success of all the companies that you do. In this day and age of social media, how important is your business and businesses to keep innovating moving forward?
It's important. Mm-hmm. I can just say one word, it's important.
Definitely, definitely. Yeah. So entrepreneurship, right? Entrepreneurship is something that a lot of people want to do, but some people can't do it well. Now, excitement is a key thing to have in an entrepreneurship. What excites you day to day in entrepreneurship?
Something new.
Yes, yes.
More dreams.
Yeah.
And before the second dream gets over, I start thinking about the third.
Do you know, I like the fact that you said the third there, because you know, it leads quite nicely. I'm not giving you my passport because you're passport control. I just want you to see my middle name there. What's my middle name?
Diamonds.
Diamonds. Wow. So that leads quite nicely to the next question. Yeah. Now you are about to, because we're in Cape Town, right? Yeah. And obviously, normally you're in the palace, your residence in Dubai, you're doing stuff all around the world, but you're in Cape Town because you're about to go into the diamonds industry,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
So, and my name is, the middle name is Diamonds, right? But so what made you want to go into this industry? Obviously, the wealth side of things, but what's exciting?
I don't leave my core business very easily. Mm. You know, my core business is real estate, and I'm always focused. I always tell to all my followers and the new generation, don't do 10 things at a time. Mm. First of all, have blessings from your parents. Mm. Think well before you do a venture. Mm. Even if you lost, do it again. I don't like to do many things, mm-hmm. but I have a friend, he's a very close friend of mine, mm-hmm. and he has pushed me to this new venture, actually.
I like that. Yeah. I like that. I think I know who you're talking about. can I talk about the importance of God in what you do? Obviously, you know, a lot of businesses, but a lot of people don't actually know that a lot of successful entrepreneurs really have a close relationship with God. How important is, you know, seeking the guidance from God in what you do?
See, there is one God.
Yes.
And I believe in all the prophets, you know. I believe in Christianity, I believe in Hinduism, I believe in Islam, I believe in all religions. I just say there is one God, and all the messengers have said the same thing. Be good with your neighbors, be fair, do charity.
Yes.
You know, don't look at other things, you know. And for example, if I see someone doing better than me, I wish them the best.
Yes, actually, you know? Yes, yes.
Because that's his luck.
Definitely, definitely. Yeah. Shouldn't be no competition.
I don't pray a lot.
Yeah.
I just, but I pray in the morning for 2 to 3 minutes. Mm-hmm. When I get up first thing, I pray for my parents that their soul is in heaven. Mm-hmm. And I wish for the best for my kids. And then I say to God, don't give me ego.
I love that.
Yeah, don't give me ego.
I love that. Yeah. I love that. I mean, that is such a... I mean, you say it very simple, but the simplest things are so strong. A lack of ego. I keep saying, you know, you have to kill your ego if you want to get to the next level. It's so important. Now, you talked about charity there. And one thing about you is beyond business, you're very, very much involved in giving back and loads of charities.
Yes, I love it.
And things like that. Why do you think it's important for you to give back? Because you don't have to. You don't have to. But why do you think it's important for you to be involved in charities and giving back?
You know, when you give charity, even that's a business, by the way. Mm. You're opening doors for yourself.
Definitely. I thought you were going to say tax, but no, that's not what we're talking about.
We don't have taxes in our country, in Dubai especially. And I just have a belief in me that if you give a dollar, mm-hmm. the same day you get a 10 back from God.
True. That 10. Is true. Now let's talk about the law of attraction. It's very important to think positively and to keep your mind in a positive state. Is that something that you lead by?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. How do you do it? What's your method?
Walking.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. I walk 2 hours a day. When I walk, I think positive. I think about my next venture. I think about my family. I just think about how to give to the community back.
Definitely.
Walking has changed my life. I should tell you, like, you know, you should, if you don't, what does walking help you? If you walk, it's good for your health. And if you're good to yourself, you're good to others.
I like that.
I don't like such people, you know, like who just make money, and they don't take care of their health. For what is this wealth if you don't have health?
That is true. Now, actually leads quite nicely to the next question, which is work-life balance, right? I mean, we've interviewed so many entrepreneurs, from Richard Branson to, you know, the list goes on, Alan Sugar, etc. And one thing they keep saying is how to keep the balance, right? Especially when you have a multitude of companies and you're launching new companies as well. How do you manage to keep that balance between work-life and obviously family as well?
Sleep early.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So what's your routine like? Yeah.
I get up 6 o'clock in the morning, mm-hmm. go for an hour walk, mm-hmm. then I go to all my construction sites, mm-hmm. then I see my CEO, COO, CFOs, I meet them, have regular meetings. Mm-hmm. By 5 o'clock I go home, mm-hmm. I like to have a 30 minutes power nap, mm-hmm. then my dinner meetings start. I love to have early dinner, mm-hmm. and it's not a dinner actually, it's all meetings.
Yes.
Because there is no day of my life I don't meet new people. Mm-hmm. I love meeting people.
Amazing.
I love learning.
Amazing. Yeah. I love that. Now, let's go on personal reflection. It's just a very simple game. We do all the people we get on the Business TV show. It's a small game called Top 3, right? It's just top 3 things that are, you know, special about you, your personality. You know, because I mean, if you were a doctor, we can't talk about hospitals the whole day. We've got to talk about certain things that you do outside of hospitals. So number one, top 3 best countries to do business in or just to go on holiday?
Dubai.
Yes.
Moscow.
Okay.
I think third is going to be Cape Town.
There you go, Cape Town. You got a lead there. Okay, wait. Top three entrepreneurs that when you think about, you're like, do you know what? I actually like how they have conducted themselves in business and their personal lives as well.
You know, for me, there is only one legend. He's the ruler of Dubai.
Oh, yes. Yes.
I follow him. Yes. I listen to him.
Yes.
I see the way he helps people. Yes. The way he handles each and everything in his life.
So what are you saying, Abu? He's top one, top two, top three?
He's everything.
I love that. I love that. Now, top three life lessons that you can say that this is something that if you were a young entrepreneur or if you were an established older entrepreneur, you're watching this right now, you're like, you know what? These are life lessons that, you know, it would be nice to live by.
Stay away from emotions.
Wow, stay away from emotions. This is very important. I want it to sink in. Sometimes people say, you know, it's not personal, it's business. So stay away from emotions, I like that.
Give more time to your family.
Give more time to your family. Yes, I like
that. Make more money.
And make more money. So if you stay away from emotions, you give more time to your family, what's gonna happen is you're gonna make more money. That's it. But the last one is, you know, I know secretly, Abu, you are a big music fan. I know you have a lot of music, you like a lot of music. What will be your top three best musicians of all time? You can go from way back.
There is one more, Black Coffee.
Oh, he's from South Africa. That's good. See, everyone's nodding. They all like that.
I always love to hear Black Coffee. Then I love one Arabic lady. She's a Moroccan. I don't know. I just remember her songs, but I don't know her name. And the third is, I love old music.
Oh, yeah.
Old songs, Indian songs. I like ghazals. Mm. So there's no three. I could say I have many.
There's a lot.
I love music, yeah.
There's a lot. So final question. Final question to you is, you know, we always want to ask people what they want their legacy to be.
A man who gives a lot of charity.
I like that. Saying about charity, we got you a small present here. It's from Deschevelle. This is one of my brands. I would love to see you wear that. I mean, sure. Deschevelle is amazing. That's our present to you. And Abu, it's been lovely to have you on the show. We always say on our show, it's about giving people their flowers when they can smell them. And you are someone who's inspired a lot of people, just in Dubai, but all across the world, in the USA, in the UK, in Europe, in South Africa, all across the world. Keep shining, keep doing what
you're doing.
And keeping all the entrepreneurs and people motivated. Thank you for coming on the Business TV show. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Join us next time on the Business TV show exclusive on VooVix TV. Subscribe to VooVix TV today by going to www.voovix.com.